live.
We're live. Hey guys, how are you? Jeff Gellman Seminars, Canine Training. And one more great idea for you to do while you're home, possibly either quarantine at home, or you're working from home, or you're home a lot with your dog. If you have a treadmill, if you don't have a treadmill, treadmills are actually pretty easy to buy, used. Actually, there's a video on YouTube that I put out, how to buy a used treadmill, because you want to check for certain things. You can use a human treadmill. We're going to put Rio on the treadmill. We have some dogs that hate the treadmill. If you watch some of my treadmill videos on YouTube, you'll see some dogs struggle on the treadmill. But when they struggle, we stick to it, and I can go over a little bit of the things that happen. So usually when I have a dog on a treadmill, dogs on a prong collar, you would think, oh my gosh, you shouldn't use a prong collar because the dog will get hurt. It's like, actually, it's the safest thing. Also, never leave the dog unattended. You stay by the dog, hold on the leash the whole time. Eventually, I'm sure some of you have seen back in especially our board and play area, dogs on the treadmill, like two, three, four right next to each other, or three right next to each other, and then a couple dogs on place. Those are dogs that have been on treadmills hundreds of times, and there's always somebody in the room supervising. So they know the treadmill drill pretty well. The first thing you wanna do with your dog on the treadmill, it's just walk right up. Make sure the dog actually goes on the treadmill. Some dogs will not go, break. Some dogs will not go up on the treadmill. If they don't go, believe it or not, you use leash pressure. It's like, it's a treadmill. The dog will get over it. If you want to lure the dog with food up there, you can if you want to. And bring them back up. Good. Good job, buddy. Let's go. So you do a bunch of reps like that. Then what's gonna happen is this. You've got dogs that when they struggle. So what happens is a couple of things. I'm gonna start at 1 mile per hour, or approximately, this one doesn't even have an odometer, speedometer on it. So I'm not gonna even know how fast I'm going. I'm just gonna gauge it. But ideally 1 mile per hour. The goal is you need all four paws to move. Once all four paws are moving, you're gonna win. You have dogs, though, that will flatten to the ground. You have dogs that will put on the brakes. You have dogs that will bite at the leash. You'll have dogs that might try to nip your leg. It's like, oh my gosh, this is terrible. It's like, no, they just don't know. They don't understand it. The ground is moving. So what you want to do is, if the dog is freaking out a little bit, you're going to be holding the leash down like this and let it freak out. Hold your ground. As long as the dog's legs are moving, hold your ground. It looks messy. It looks very messy. I cannot tell you how many dogs that we have that jump onto this treadmill with no leash, that run on it for half an hour, and they started out with it very messy. So don't be afraid of the messy part. It freaks dogs out. If you've been to any of my seminars, you'll see when we demonstrate some dogs really struggle. But you know, within 30 seconds, they're like walking on it. And then all of a sudden, you stop after about 1 or 2 minutes, you take them off, put them back on, and they're fine. So if the dog freaks out totally, don't you freak out as well. The dog will do it. If the dog freaks out and you immediately stop, the dog's gonna think, oh, see, freaking out works. I don't have to do the treadmill. All right, so what I want you to do is, I'm gonna start putting the dog up on the treadmill like this. Let's go. I walk dogs on the left, so I'm putting my left leg right here next to the dog. I'm putting my other leg here. That's because if the dog tries to slide its butt off, I can also use my foot like this. Ideally, you can put the treadmill up against a wall. You can actually stick your treadmill in a corner so the dog can't jump off. So your front is covered, your side is covered, and then you're covered like this. Okay? You can also, if you want to, take some cardboard and make like a little chute. So now you've got like a little chute that the dog is going into. That keeps dogs a little bit better centered as well. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to be prepared for the dog to totally freak out. So look how close my hand is to the leash. I'm not gonna go like this because the dog can just jump off too easily. So I'm gonna hold the dog's leash just like this, because if this dog starts freaking out, I wanna be able to, you know, joystick it. We always tell you don't joystick, but I want you to be able to joystick it. So here we go. You want to do it from the front? Where do you want to film this from? From the front?
What's probably from the side right here. It's fine, okay, yeah.
Cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the treadmill and... I got all four paws to move. Now, let's say the dog was freaking out. I would still hold. We just don't have a dog that would freak out on the treadmill here right now. So I got to show you a dog that is just gets on the treadmill. I would hold the leash really close right here, and I wouldn't let the dog freak out. I would just hold my ground. I've seen dogs have the biggest hissy fits in the world. It sounds mean. It's like, oh, you know, lure them with food. It's like they're not going to take anything. They don't want to take anything at all. So hold your ground. As long as you have all four paws moving, you're going to win. When you hold your ground like this, you're going to win. The dog will eventually calm down and start walking. And then once you get your first good, you know, say 1 to 2 minutes of good walk, stop your treadmill. And as soon as the dog stops the treadmill, you can also put your dog into an SIT or a sit. And then you will say, break. Okay? And then you have the dog come off the treadmill. You always release the dog off the treadmill. We don't want the dog to think that it can get off the treadmill on its own. And then let's say the dog had a horrific first experience. Believe it or not, you're able to work the dog through that. So then next thing you do, have go up again another time. Let's go. And go up again another time. And then this time, it's gonna work out even better. So the first experience was bad. Do the treadmill and get prepared. That's a little bit fast.
She's like, I'm ready. She loves it.
Yeah.
Good girl, Rio.
This has a funky setting on it.
It's yeah, it's like a slide bar. It's not a digital treadmill.
Yeah. And start at about 1 mile per hour. Start at half a mile per hour, get up to 1 mile per hour. But believe it or not, when you take your dog for a walk, most people walk at about 3 to 3.5 miles per hour. So 2 miles per hour on a treadmill is not too much. If you actually go too slow, it doesn't really work because it's not a natural cadence for a dog. So the treadmill is not just about exercise. So this is not like you're trying to build an athlete here. The treadmill, especially the slower speed, actually teaches that dog impulse control, patience, all right? A lot of things. If you've got a dog that's touch sensitive, once they're on the treadmill and they start walking, let's say this dog didn't like to be petted, a pet on the head, you can start petting the dog on the head. If it didn't like to be handled, you can start handling it on the treadmill. Why? Because it's focusing so much on the treadmill. It's focusing so much on the treadmill. All right? So that's today's stay-at-home dog training tip of the day, treadmill training. Any questions?
Somebody said... There's a couple questions. How big does the dog need to be to require a dog treadmill versus a human treadmill?
I mean, you know, your average treadmill deck is probably about 60 inches. So, you know, what you want to do is if I had like a big jerk, what you don't want is you don't want the back legs coming off the bottom of this. You know, always coming off the bottom. You don't want the dog too far back because the back leg is always coming off the back. Your dog can get a repetitive injury. Your Great Danes and your huge dogs are probably gonna need a bigger 72-inch deck treadmill. They might need a special, an actual dog treadmill. They make dog treadmills. They make them actually pretty long. But a dog like, you know, a dog even bigger than this, you know, I can fit a good-sized German Shepherd still on that treadmill because they're only taking up so much space and you're standing right there. So the next step actually, let's go. After I got the dog getting comfortable on the treadmill,
you gotta push this thing back in.
After getting the dog on the treadmill, is I would step 1 foot down, like that. That's the next step. 1 foot down, like that. And now I've got, you know, I'm not micromanaging as much. And then eventually, I would go like this. But if the dog tried to jump off, I'd be like, oh, foot's back up there. Foot's back up there.
Someone said, what do you do if the dog pancakes?
Pancake dogs, start it, see what happens. Within about 3 to 5 seconds, though, stop. But believe it or not, if the dog pancakes, but you keep a little bit of pressure, the dog might get up. But if the dog is totally pancaking and you're dragging it, stop immediately. If the dog is put on all four paw brakes, like literally, I'm not going anywhere, stop. Do not rip the pads. But as long as the dog is going, making any type of movement at all, even if it's freaking out, stick to it. I've seen the messiest starts turn into the best treadmill dogs. They just don't know, they don't understand it. The ground is moving. Plus there's also some sound there too. So the ground is moving and there's some sound.
Would you recommend a programmable variable speed, the kind that would speed up, slow down, etc.?
You could. It's more about just builds confidence in the dog. It's good for, you think about it, it's good for, you could be working out while the dog's on the treadmill. You can be, eventually you can tie the leash to the treadmill. The dog gets so good.
That was going to be someone's next question. What do you tie her to when she's doing it?
Yeah, you tie her to the treadmill. You can actually, if you want to take get a wooden bar and run it across here, tie it to the wooden bar, you would do that. Some dogs, come here, sweetheart. Some dogs need a little bit more help. I'm not opposed to having a dog. If you have to start a dog like this and like really, really guide them on it, you can do that. But I would say that 95% of the dogs that I've worked with, I've started just like that. I've never been able to not get a dog to be successful on the treadmill. So pancaking though, it's like do your best to lift the dog up. Get them moving. You got to get all four paws moving. Once you get all four paws moving, you're gold. What else? Any other questions?
I think that's it.
Okay. So the treadmill is not for lazy people. Let's just talk about that. It's not for lazy people. It's for like middle of a snowstorm. There's no place to walk. Some people don't feel comfortable walking at night. Some people can't leave their house because there's whether they're a single parent or they work a different shift and you've got kids. It's like you can't leave your kids at home alone. It also allows the dog to do one more activity during the day than while you get other stuff done eventually. It's also good for the mind. We do treadmill training probably more for the mind than we do to like tire the dog out. We're not trying to tire the dog out physically on the treadmill. You could, but that's actually not the goal. The goal is actually, it's mental. It's mental stimulation. It's mental stimulation. It's also getting dogs over fear. It also helps dogs build confidence. It's a big confidence booster in a lot of dogs. All right, what else?
I think that's it.
Okay, good. And then there's sometimes just areas where like it's just not, you might have a dog that's not good outside with dogs.
Or you might be in the middle of a virus epidemic.
Yeah, exactly, where they're encouraging you to stay home. But walking your dog outside in fresh air is actually a good thing to do.
True that.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
That's it. All right, awesome, guys. Jeff Gellman, Sally Canine Training. So we're thinking about you. We're all in the same boat, madly in love with all of you. And just remember, it's going to end. All right? Love you guys.